This is part two of our momentum integral balance, and I'll draw the picture again. So we have a 30 degree reducing bend. It looks like this. We have a V1, our V2 coming out here, and this is 30 degrees. One thing I do want to remind you, this is part of a pipe, so neither one nor two are open to the atmosphere. And let me remind you of some of the things that we already calculated or were given to us. So our P1 was given as 200 kilopascals, and we calculated our P2 using Bernoulli's as 101.6 kilopascals. Our V1 was 9.6 meters per second. Where we got that is we started with a mass flow rate of 300 kilograms per second. Our V2 is 17 meters per second. The diameter in section one is 0.2 meters, and the diameter in section two is 0.15 meters, where this is section one and this is section two. Finally, as you can see, our theta is 30 degrees. And what we're asked to do here is now find the y component of the force required to hold the bend in place. So one of the things that makes this problem a little bit easier, this part of the problem, is that we have no velocity and no pressure in the y direction coming in. So all we're looking for is what's coming out or happening at section two. So we start with our momentum at section two. So that's rho. And now we have to find our little v, which is the y component of velocity. So let's take a look here. Here's our v2. Here's our 30 degrees. And here's our y component. So the y component is going to be v2 sine of theta. However, if you notice, and again, let's draw our coordinate system, that this is in the negative y direction, so our v is negative. Then we find v dot n, and the normal and the velocity are parallel to each other, so the angle between them is 0. Cosine of 0 is 1, so v dot n is just v2. And now this equals coming out the sum of our forces, and now we're going to look at the pressure, which is P2, that's coming in, and again, we need this horizontal component of P2, sorry, the vertical component, and that's P2 sine of theta. And as you can notice, it's in the positive direction. Both of these are multiplied by area 2, and this is the force that's needed to keep the bend in place in the y direction. So r sub y is just minus rho v2 squared sine of theta times a2 minus p2 sine of theta a2. And when we put in our density and the numbers that we have already calculated, we find that R equals minus 3,443 newtons. And again, I want to remind you that you need to put these pressures in pascals. So you just multiply them times 10 to the third.